Good morning. We're learning a mimer. Was said in 1930. Was actually said on the second day of Rosh Hashanah.
1930?
Mm-hmm. I'm sorry, 1970. Tavshin Lamed. This mimer was said on the second day of Rosh Hashanah. And it opens with the words Uvachodesh Hashviei. So from the month of Nisan to the month of Tishrei, you have 7 months. Chodesh Hashviei be'echad la'chodesh. Mikra chodesh yelochem kol melech savid aleisasu. Says, it comes to the 7th month. Be'echad la'chodesh means the first day of the month. Mikra chodesh yelochem. It should be a holy day to you, to Bnei Yisrael, to the Jewish people. Come alech, savi l'sasu, yoyim truo yelochem. It's a day that you should not do work, and a day that you should sound the shofar. Isa midrash be'echad l'chodesh z'avom shenemar echad avom. It says in the prophecy of Yechezkel that Be'echod L'Chodesh is referencing to Avraham Avinu. Why? Because it says about Avraham, Echod Oy Avraham. Mikra Chodesh Zeh Yaakov. Shenema Shema Eila Yaakov. This is a prophecy of Yishai. The Shema Eila Yaakov. In the prophecy of Yeshaya, Hashem is telling the Jewish people, it says, Shema Eila Yaakov, V'Yisrael Mekoiroi. So Mekoiroi is also said with Yaakov Yisrael. So when it says Mikro, Mekoiroi, is the same thing. Same words or same letters. So referencing to Yaakov. So far we skipped the Yitzchak. We said Echod is Avram, Echod Avram. Mikro Kodesh referencing to Yaakov because it says in Yeshaya, Shema Eila Yaakov Yisrael Mekoiroi. And Yom Teruah is Yitzchak. And Dev Tua is referencing to Yitzchak Shenema Vayar Vine Ail. Since the shofar that we use in Rosh Hashanah is a shofar made out of a ram's horn, so it's referencing to Yitzchak. In the Akedah, in the Parsha of the Akedah, right, in Parshas Vayero, it says Vayar v'inayin. We read it every day. Tzoruch lo v'inayin seder ovei so Avraham Yitzchak v'Yaakov. Lam v'kosav z'makti mikra kodesh z'Yaakov lifne zichro intruo z'Yitzchak. The Rabbi is asking, 1 second. The order should be Avraham, Yitzchak, and Yaakov. And this pasuk, Chodesh Hashviei, the first pasuk of the Maimah that we're dealing with. Parshas Pinchas 29a, chapter 29, verse 1. It says, Chodesh Hashviei, in the 7th month, Be'echod l'chodesh Avram, Mikra Chodesh Yaakov, Yom Teruah Yitzchak. Why the pasuk is describing the Oveis out of order, right? Should have been Avraham Yitzchak and Yaakov, not Avraham Yaakov and Yitzchak. Get the question?
Why is he last?
Why is putting Yitzchak last?
Yeah.
The pasuk is doing it because the pasuk tells us Echod is Avraham, Mikra is Yaakov, and Yom Teruah is Yitzchak. Uriesa Yukshe, the question becomes even more. Shapasha Semo Shalov Doshu be Echot Zavrom. Pasha Semo, where it says Echot is Echot de Avrom, Echot is referring to Avrom. Ksiv Bachidish Hashvi be Echot Lachidish. It's written Bachidish Hashvi, the seventh month. Echot Lachidish, the first of the month. Zichon Tuo Mikro Kedish. What does it mean? If you're mentioning Echod, that's Avram. Zichro Yitro is Yitzchak. And Mikra Kodesh is Yaakov. So you can mention the pasuk that writes it in the, that puts all of them in the right order. Because Mash Vayok Sibachodesh Hashvi, Echod Lachodesh Avram, Zichro Yitro Yitzchak. And Mikra Kodesh Yaakov. In this inyan, the pasuk is writing the ovis in the order. The question is on Parshas Pinchas. Parshas Pinchas nemo mikra kodesh shereimiz al Yaakov lifnei zichron truo shereimiz al Yitzchok. Why in Parshas Pinchas is out of order? Chayinu kfi shemvot zemach tzedek. Third Lubavitch Rebbe. In his book called Eir HaTero, Shkivon Shalpozish Parshas Pinchas Ubenigya Linyan Musafi. Since the pasuk in Parshas Pinchas is speaking about the Musaf, the Korbanis of Musaf, that they would bring in the Beis HaMikdash on Shabbos and on Rosh Chodesh and the Yomim Tovim festivals. So the pasuk is describing which korbanis, which musaf korbanis you need to bring on Rosh Hashanah. What does it say? Vasisim oilo, you have to bring burnt offering. Vsukim oilo imrim tfilas musaf shel Rosh Hashanah. Vekoyrim b'maftir shel Rosh Hashanah. Umusofin boim v'bchinas Yosef. It says in Kabbalah that Musaf and Yosef have similarity in their in the word Musaf and Yosef. And Musafim is coming from the level of Yosef. We said in the davening of Musaf in Rosh Hashanah, Vasisim Oil. Lo, chenigdim akosu Yaakov Yitzchok, ki eile toldis Yaakov Yosef. Why the pasuk mentioned Yaakov? Before Yitzchok. Ki eile toldis Yaakov Yosef. So there is a special shaychus, a special connection to the Musafin. Musaf is Yosef. Musaf is the Korbanos of Rosh Hashanah, Korbanos that you have to bring, especially on Rosh Hashanah. So since Yosef is connected with Musafin, and since Yosef is told this Yaakov Yosef, descendants of Yaakov are Yosef, there is an emphasis on Yaakov, that is before Yitzchak, mentioned before Yitzchak. Okay, that's an Bederich Efshar. I mean, it's an answer, obviously, the Rebbe brings it. But let's see if the Rebbe is satisfied with that answer. V'inyan ha'shaychus shel aviz in Beis, right? V'inyan ha'shaychus shel aviz v'pozim v'chodesh ha'shvi'i. Eitav midrash. What's the connection between the aviz? The pasuk in Bechodesh Hashvi'i, it amin shom, vayikra bo. What's the moshul? Moshul levnei leven melochim. Shalo din vevnei ovid. A prince had a judgment, and his father the judge. Omar leoviv matavakish niskiz lefone bedin bayim ze. If you want to be meritorious on this day. The father is telling his son how to be meritorious in judgment. What he needs to do to be meritorious. Hashem says to the Jewish people, so, Bini, my son, my children, if you want to be meritorious on this day, mention the merits of your forefathers, of the patriarchs. V'atem zeichin lefon abadin, and you will be meritorious in judgment. So that's why it's hinted in the pasuk in Rosh Hashanah be'echod. Be'echod v'chodesh, be'echod z'avrom. V'chul. And as we said, Mikol Kodesh is Yitzchak, Mikol Kodesh is Yaakov, Yom Tov is Yitzchak. V'moset Yom Askin Zchuz Aveis. And when should you mention the merits of the fathers, of the patriarchs? V'atem Zichin Lefon Ebedin V'Chodesh Hashvi. When you should mention it in the seventh month, month of Tishrei, and you'll be meritorious in judgment.
I mean,
like Avram, like Yitzchok, like Yaakov, like Lagoda, Gibor, Margin Avram. Every davening every Shmoneh Esrei, you're mentioning the always.
Three times a day.
So what's a chiddush? Are you going to be to Shon Shmoneh Bechol, you're going to be Avram, Chon Shmoneh, and Skir, and Skir, and Skir, and Skir, and Tfilo, and Bakadom, and Bakadom, and Tfilo. We always mention it before we start in the beginning of Shmoneh Esrei. What's the novelty of mentioning the obvious is specifically Rosh Hashanah?
The question becomes even more.
The davening of every day, we're mentioning the merits of the patriarchs, Elikei Aviseinu, the gods of our forefathers, Elikei Avraham, Elikei Yitzchak, Elikei Yaakov. Mentioning it directly. Mashenken Azkor Zchusov Shel Rosh Hashanah Rak Beremez. Mentioning Zchusov Shel Rosh Hashanah, it's hint. It's only a remez. You need to bring raya, you need to be proof. She'echod, it says echod ayavom, mikro, Yisrael mikroi, in Yeshaya, and then Yom Teruo, it's connected with Yitzchak, it's not even direct. That you're mentioning Zchus Ovis. Echod ayavom, mikro, kezi Yitzchak, Yaakov, Zichon Teruo, ze Yitzchak, in Cain, ma chidush basko Zchus Ovis. What's the novelty of mentioning the merits of the forefathers? She Iraq beremez, alas goes so befeirush. It's only a remez. It's not directly mentioning of Amitzok and Yaakov. Ma'u achidush, alas goes chusav shroshon, she Iraq beremez, alas goes chusav befeirush, but feirush b'chol yeim. Achai yenu shmal asasko aschus oviz b'Rosh Hashanah. Shiyin Rosh Hashanah atzma mitzius shel oviz. So says, what is the milo of mentioning the merits of the forefathers? He tells you the Rosh Hashanah is the metzius of the Ovis. Meaning, Rosh Hashanah is the Ovis. Avraham, Yitzchak, v'Yaakov. So, Mazkirim Zchus Ovis is you mentioning something that happened in the past. But over here is telling us that the Ovis is the concept of Rosh Hashanah. It's not something else. If you notice, what is the parsha we read in Rosh Hashanah? First day, Avraham Pokad et Tzoro. Second day is the Akedah. Everything is the Ovis. The whole Metzius of Rosh Hashanah is the Ovis. It's not like that we're mentioning the Ovis every day. There's just a Zikorin, just a remembrance. Ella be'efen she'im Rosh Hashanah atzma hu ha-metziu shel Ovis. Rosh Hashanah itself, that's the metziu of Avraham, Yitzchak, and Yaakov. V'chelosh ha-midrash be'echod zeh Avraham. V'ayinu she'echod la'chedesh she'im Rosh Hashanah yiyim zeh atzma hu Avraham. That day is Avraham. V'chel mikra kedesh zeh Yaakov. V'zichro in truo zeh Yitzchak. Oh no. So far we learned that the chiddush of Rosh Hashanah mentioning the Ovis is not just mentioning the Ovis. We understand that that day is the metzius of the Ovis. That's their day. Oh no, magufa tzoch biu ma shach Rosh Hashanah Ovis shem Rosh Hashanah atzmi zavro. Need to understand why does. Telling me the Rosh Hashanah is Avraham. That day is Avraham. The inya shayichus shir askos of the tefillah kol echad ve'echad v'yisrael b'chol yeim kol echad ve'echad v'yisrael lech b'dach ha'v'yisrael Avraham Yitzchak Yaakov. Why are we mentioning Avraham Yitzchak and Yaakov every day? It says because every Jew walks in the ways of Avraham Yitzchak and Yaakov. Chaydu ha'efer shebein ovis la'shuvotim. We know the difference between the Ovis, the forefathers, and the tribes. Shein kolim Ovis ela l'shlisha. Who do we call Ovis? Only to these three. Avraham, Yitzchak, and Yaakov. Ki b'inyan ha'shvotim yesh chilukim. Comes to the Shvotim, there are differences in Avodas Hashem. Chol shevet b'msilos yal. Every tribe goes in his mesila, his path. Every tribe has its path in Avodas Hashem. She'elu shemishavet Reuven avidasim b'kav shel Reuven. For example, those that are coming from the tribe of Reuven, the Aveda is Re'ia, Reuven. It's the seeing godliness. Chamegal shevet Shimon. Shimon is Shmia, hearing. Levi v'Yehuda. She'en kem negal l'Ovis. He says like this. When it comes to the tribes, whatever tribes you are, that's your avodah, that's your path in life. But when it comes to the Ovis, every single Jew has to have Avraham, Yitzchak, and Yaakov in him. Just because you are Reuven or Shimon or Levi, you still have to have Avraham, Yitzchak, and Yaakov. It says the commandments in the Torah were said in such a way, such an expression, that it's also a promise. The commandment itself is a promise. For example, there is a commandment to love Hashem your God. So it's a commandment that you need to love Hashem, and also a promise. The Torah is promising every Jew that he would come to Avas Hashem. They're commanding you and promising you that it's going to happen. הרי כן הוא גם באומור, כל אחד ואחד מסוד, זה ראש מיניונם של כל אובס, every single Jew has to have from אבו המשחוק עם יעקב. שזה עצמו יאהב תוך, it's a promise, שבכל אחד מסוד יום של כל אובס. That every single Jew has something from the obvious. Inyonum shekol obvious, not just something. Inyonum, their inyon, their essence. Kavu b'tanya shebuchol echad misol shbe'elam avavir. It says in Tanya that every single Jew has, if not in a revealed way, in a concealed way, love and awe. Avas Hashem, yiras Hashem, love of God, fear of God, v'anafeim, and the branches of it, which is the midos, the emotive attributes that are expanding from it, the extension of Aven Yira, Aven Oa, both the Birushim, obviously they're coming as an inheritance from from Avraham Yitzchak Yaakov, even without him toiling to reveal it. Be'inyan zeh, this hidden love and hidden fear that are coming from the obvious, it's not only in a concealed well, but if it's a gamba begilu, also in a way that it's in such a way that it's revealed. That's why every single Jew, that's why every single Jew need a reveal or need a can, meaning he's unable and he doesn't want to be separated from Elikus, the Rebbe writes. So when there is a Chas Shalom in Yisrael, a test, a Jew will be willing to Meisa Nefesh, even if he's on the lowest level, because at that point it's revealed in him that he doesn't want and cannot be separated. Since every single Jew has the concept of within him, the obvious, Avraham Yitzchak and Yaakov, that's why we're mentioning the merits of our forefathers. This inyan is connected with Hashanah. Since every single Jew follows the ways of Avraham Yitzchak and Yaakov, that's why their merit is beneficial. You walk in their ways, you follow their ways. That's why Moil Zchusam, the Zchus is beneficial to you. Chol Echad V'Echad Mishrol, Shenimshach L'Rov Tuv, for every single Jew that they have Rov Tuv, abundance of good, Beribui Muflag, lots of good, Beribui Muflag, with Shefa, with overflowing, Miyodam Leo Psucha Gdesho Archova, from his open hand, from his holy hand, from his broad hand, written and sealed for a good year, sweet year, Beteva Niva Niglin, also revealed good, not just hidden good, not just concealed good, revealed good. Avadain Tzarech Lov, Ma'ashech, Lomichot Shel Roshon Oves, Yom Roshon Atzma, Metzius Shel Oves, Be'echot Zeh Avraham V'chud. So you have to understand the Shaychus, the special connection that the Oves have, the Oves is having with Rosh Hashanah. Okay? Be'echot Zeh Avraham V'chud. As we said so far, the Echot Avraham, Mikro Kodesh, or Mikro Kodesh is Yaakov, and Yom Tuah Yitzchak. We'll continue, God willing, tomorrow.